President Trump's latest Fox News interview is causing controversy. This was Trump's 55th interview with Fox since Inauguration Day. That's more than double all of his interviews with every other major network combined. But this newest one was different. He was in France, there to honor the soldiers who sacrificed their lives on D-Day. He sat down with Fox News host Laura Ingraham, right there, right with the graves of soldiers as the backdrop. What was he thinking? What was she thinking? What were the Fox producers thinking when Trump went on a tirade? Look, Trump did take a moment to tell Ingraham how proud he is of her ratings.
By the way, congratulations on your ratings. I'm very proud.
Thank you very much.
And that wasn't even the worst part. Trump took the opportunity to attack Nancy Pelosi and Robert Mueller. Take a look.
Nancy Pelosi's a disaster. Nasty, vindictive, horrible person. She's a nervous wreck. Their good friend Bobby Mueller. We have crying Chuck Schumer. He's a total political, you know, jerk.
What could you do to unite the country at a time of great polarization? What else could you do?
That is a great question, Laura. Attacking your critics? Attacking those you disagree with, including Robert Mueller, who's a veteran, at a gravesite is not helping anybody unite anything. And look, as I watched this interview and I watched the terrible optics, I wondered, where is President Trump's communications director to oversee what the camera shots look like? Who's working to protect him from those kinds of gaffes? Well, let's remember, former Fox executive Bill Shine exited the White House in March, and now the job remains vacant more than 3 months later. Maybe Trump isn't his own best communications director. Look, I think there's a lot to discuss from this interview and so much more. Let's bring in New York Magazine senior correspondent Erin Carmone, CNN media analyst Bill Carter, and the host of SE Cup Unfiltered here on CNN SE Cup. What do you think of this Laura Ingraham interview, SE? We both are working here in television day by day. I don't think either of us would have allowed that kind of embarrassing situation to happen.
Well, you know as well as I do, a lot of prep goes into doing our show when we're on set, but certainly and especially when you're out on location somewhere. What's the backdrop going to be? What kind of permits do we have to get? I mean, there's a lot of steps that you have to take to designing this shot, this interview. The idea that someone said, let's put the president of the United States, who frequently runs off on the mouth, at the mouth, is probably not going to hew to social norms while we're here.
Right.
Let's put him in front of a graveyard on one of the most sacred occasions and conduct an interview in which we ask him about politics. That was a vetted decision. That was on purpose. I don't think they're stupid. I just don't think it was polite. I don't think it was the right thing to do.
Bill, do you think it matters?
Well, it doesn't matter to the audience that he has.
I don't think
it
matters. To the Fox
audience. It doesn't really matter to them. That's not going to offend them. But I think Fox was trying to, you know, elevate him by giving him that background. I think they were trying to put him in the best possible situation.
Oh, I see. Make him look presidential.
Make him look presidential and connect him to the sacrifice of these great soldiers, great American soldiers. But he's totally unpredictable. They know he's going to say something outrageous, and it doesn't faze them to think, well, the backdrop will be awful. The Mueller comment is really amazing in terms of what it says about him, because this is a guy who did not go to Vietnam for a, obviously, kind of phony impairment, and a guy who did go and was wounded and all that, he criticizes in front of an American graveyard. The optics are really terrible in that cut.
We continue to see cases, including this week with the president in Europe, where he tells you not to believe your own ears or your own eyes. He did this when talking about protests. He said he hadn't seen the protests, so maybe they were fake news. But I thought the most interesting use of the term fake news this week was from Laura Ingraham. Did y'all see this? After the interview with the president, she had to go on her show and say, the president said something that wasn't true. Watch this clip.
These people are so amazing. And what they don't realize is that I'm holding them up because of this interview, but that's because it's you.
Some of you may have heard or read that President Trump supposedly held up the entire D-Day ceremony in order to do this interview with me. That is patently false, fake news.
Amazing to see a Fox host correcting the president like that. She didn't say that it was the president that made up this idea. What actually happened was one of the other foreign leaders was running a little bit late, and so there was time for Trump to do the interview before the ceremony. But what did you make of that, Erin?
Well, I think we're in the panopticon, right? We're in the M.C. Escher of BS right now, because what happens is it doesn't matter what reality is. It just matters what the perception is will be good for Trump. And that for Trump himself has always been a kind of ever-shifting justification, right? He doesn't have stable truths. He just has whatever comes out of his mouth is what he thinks will benefit him the most in that exact second. Mm. And you see Laura Ingraham kind of taking her cues from that, right? Because it was something that Trump said that was not true, which she then said other people had said, which remained untrue, but was true to what the president has said. And if your head is spinning, it's kind of the point, right? It's creating a sense of disorientation. Mm. At the end of the day, you just think, well, there are the people who are against Trump, and then there are people who are not. And regardless of what the facts are, or whether they matter, what their valence are, I mean, I know this word gets abused so much in this day and age, but this is classic gaslighting. The gaslighting story is, oh no, that lamp didn't move. It must be your imagination. Oh, the president didn't say that. Or the president didn't make us late. Whatever it is, in the end, everyone else is lying, and I'm the only person telling you the truth.
Right, so just stick with your tribe and don't believe what you can see.
Don't trust your eyes.